What's going on, guys? It's OmniArk, and today I'm bringing you a brand new video where I'm going to be giving you my thoughts and opinions on the brand new Ninja Attack update. Now, I really considered not making this video because... Where's the changes? I don't see any event. I don't see any. What did they? Let me zoom in here. What did they change? Guys, here's the deal with the Ninja Attack update. This update was obviously a pretty big update because apparently made a lot of people's game lag and crash and all sorts of other stuff. They released another compensation thingy here. So it was obviously a huge update. And there was really nothing to log into and to see, right? And we kind of already knew this was going to be the case, because if you go back to the mail where they announced this update, you'll see that pretty much everything here was changes to the KVK, right? This was a huge KVK change. They've also changed the Wheel of Fortune and the Mightiest Governor, and then they're adding the Legendary Tavern. We'll talk about that in a second. But this update was basically a massive change to Season of Conquest, and it was also to implement the Ninja Gaiden crossover, which they already said is going to come about a week after the update. So most of the changes for this big update are things that we're gonna see later, and there was just nothing to see when the event went live, or when the update went live, right? And so I was like, do I even make a video about it? But I figured let's just talk about it, okay? So a couple of things that we can discuss. We've got these two avatar frames that you can get from the Assembling Scrolls event. So it looks like you don't actually buy these, you get these from the event, which is fine. And then apparently there's the what is this? This is it doesn't even give you a name. It doesn't even say. These are Ryu, whatever his name is. These are the avatars that you get, I guess, from the bundles. You can get it from the bundles. So great, cool, I guess, cool beans. I mean, I feel like if you get that with this, is this even gonna look good on this avatar frame? Like, was it built for it? It's not. It's gonna look silly. So I don't really know what's going on there. Okay, I don't really know what's going on there. But apparently, that's implemented into the game now. We've got these two Osiris League Season 4 skins here. These are actually pretty cool looking, not gonna lie. They look really, really sick. This is, I mean, I guess this is a good skin, sorta, I guess. I don't know, I probably wouldn't want to lose cavalry health, can I speak today? And then the Divine Lighthouse is awesome for the training speed, which is cool, troop health, great. But you lose a lot of archer health, so, yeah, maybe they'll use this, I don't know. I feel like you're only gonna get this if you're a top tier player, and most top tier players are rallying with archers, so... yeah, they're only going to use this for training. Anyway, let's move on to some of the other changes that we saw here in this update. No new commanders. We didn't see any new commanders here. And honestly, guys, if there's going to be a commander that comes with this Ninja Gaiden update, I will be shocked, right? Because if it hasn't leaked by now, if it hasn't leaked already, like, that's crazy how they would keep that a secret. I don't know. I also wouldn't be surprised if they started cracking down on these leaks, because these leaks are coming out really early now, and it's a lot of information that's coming out, and so I'm sure there are people over there at Lilith that are scrambling, trying to figure out who's leaking this information, how fast can we fire them. Like, it's kind of a big deal. Like, we take it for granted, right? I'm a content creator. I get views off of these things, so for me, it's great. And of course, it's risky. You know, I'm posting basically their intellectual property before they've released it to the public. That's probably not a great, you know, thing, not a great look, right? But, you know, at the end of the day, it's actually pretty bad if these leaks come out really, really early, right? Because then there's expectations set, and then people are waiting for things, and people are getting hyped for things that might not be real, and it's just a whole big deal. So yeah, if they cracked down on leakers significantly, and they drop a commander that we see that just comes out of nowhere, like, that would be incredible. I would be so hyped for that. But I think the odds are pretty low that we're getting a commander for this event. Like, almost guaranteed, right? Like, almost guaranteed we're not getting a commander for this Ninja Gaiden event. I hope we do. I doubt we will. So that's something to kind of talk about. And then I guess the biggest thing that we can talk about is that you can exchange Ethelfled sculptures for Alliance credits. This is something that I talked about in a video that I posted on October 1st, 2020. So 5 months later, 5 months after I mentioned it, they finally did it. Lilith, listen, if you need good ideas, just say so, okay? Because I'm clearly way ahead of the curve. So hit me up, call me, text me, whatever you need to do. But look, you're finally implementing something that I talked about October 1st, 2020. Like, when they announced the Alliance Reclaim Shop was going to be a thing, that's when I predict, and like, it's about time, right? And you can see, I've already exchanged all my sculptures. I got about 6 million Alliance credits. And the reason that I did that instantaneously when this event came out is because I was like, they're really giving 5,000 credits for one Aethelflaed. They're going to nerf that. They're going to nerf it. Everybody, mark my words, they're going to nerf that. So I was like, let me just sell all of them right now before they nerf that to 2,500 or something ridiculous, right? Now, I am sad to see that they didn't actually change anything else in here. They didn't change all the prices of this all good stuff. So, yeah, they still need to do this. There's stuff here that needs to be addressed, okay? But I guess you guys will get to it in 5 months. Anyway, let's talk about what we didn't see in this update. What we didn't see is a change to the Wheel of Fortune. And guys, I'm not lying. I was stoked. When I woke up, I was like, yes, dude, the update was last night. Like, this is it. Open it up and boom, Ramsey's still on the wheel. I was like, dude, really, really? We waited so long since this was first revealed or leaked or what? I don't even remember how we got the information about them changing this wheel. I think it was a leak. But regardless, I was so hyped. Like, yes, dude, they're changing the wheel. I woke up, no changes, boys. No changes. I was not a happy camper. Now, don't get me wrong, Ramses is incredible, but he's not somebody that I'm working on right now. Like, he's kind of in the background. Like, should I work on him? Maybe eventually, yeah. And I think that was a big letdown for a lot of people. I don't think I'm alone there. I think a lot of people were expecting, like, oh, the wheel is here, and this event is, this update is coming, and we're gonna get to see the new wheel and all that stuff. And it just didn't happen, right? And I think that was a huge letdown for a lot of people, because that was, like, the biggest thing about this event, or this update. Like, why do I keep saying event? This update, everyone was like, oh my god, yeah, we're gonna be able to choose the wheel, we're gonna be able to choose the Mightiest God. Are like so exciting, and you know, it did come with the update. It's just apparently it's gonna be the next, so 2 weeks from now we're gonna be able to see that change. Of course, Mightiest Governor's here as well. I don't see how they would have changed that mid-cycle, right? Because that wouldn't have been fair. But regardless, I was pretty disappointed to see that. And we also still have no word on the skill lock feature. Like, I'm actually upset that they even mentioned the skill lock feature back then, however many months ago that was. Was that like, what, 1 month, 2 months, a month and a half? It was a long time ago, right? And it's kind of ridiculous because they mentioned it once and then they don't mention it again. And like, you know, the clock is ticking, right? I'm getting bored. I'm sitting on these sculptures, boys. I gotta be real with you. I'm getting bored. Like, I want to start progressing in my account, but I need to, it's such a big feature that it's like, I could literally save hundreds of sculptures by just waiting for this feature to come into the game. And they've already mentioned it, so I'm thinking it's coming soon, but like, where is it, right? Like, where is it? They need to be a little bit more transparent. I think, right? This is just my opinion. I would like them to be a little bit more transparent about when this feature is coming. Like, do they think that it's not a big deal? Like, do they think that the skill lock feature is just like, you know, a feature that, oh yeah, they're gonna like it when it comes out, whatever. Like, no, it's a game-changing feature, right? It's game-changing, especially for low spenders, and especially even for me. Like, this, it's a big feature, and so I'm waiting for it, and until then, my account is on pause, right? And so we didn't see a lot of things with this update. And again, this update has a ton of stuff in it that you're gonna be thankful for when KVK comes around. Right now, there's just not much to see, right? There's not much to see. And I was honestly hoping to see some sort of event too. Like we know that there's a spring event coming, right? Like, and I know that it's like right now it's mid-March, so it's a little bit early for a spring event, so I get why it's not here yet. But like, there hasn't really been anything. I feel like, when was the last event that we had? Wasn't it like Valentine's Day, right? So that was like, I don't know, it just feels like there's been a while since we've had some sort of event in Rise of Kingdoms. Like, when was the last time we had a More Than Gems, like, or a recharge event? I don't know. I feel like maybe I'm wrong here. Like, I'm totally open to that. Maybe I'm just like not keeping track of these things, but I feel like we haven't had More Than Gems or recharge event or some sort of holiday event. Maybe it just feels long because we're so used to getting them from holiday, right? Like, you know, you have your Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, like all that stuff back to back to back. And then you have, you know, you have your Valentine's Day. And so like now maybe like in March, it's like kind of a dead month and it just feels weird, right? But regardless, when this update came out, I was hoping to see some sort of like monthly event here. And who knows, maybe it'll come like the last week of March or something like that. We know it's coming, right? The leaks are there. We know it's a thing. I think there's an avatar frame for it as well. So it's like actually 100% confirmed. No, it wasn't here. Where was it? It was, there was something, something was spring event themed. It wasn't a city skin. Was it one of the name plaques? Was that it? I think it was a name plaque. Yeah, this thing here. The Festival of Spring. It's only an elite. Oh, I guess a lot of these are elite. Anyway, or are they all elite? Did I just never notice that? Am I dumb? I guess I'm dumb. Anyway, you guys probably already figured that out. Anyway, let's see. Yeah, Festival of Spring. I mean, this looks pretty cool, right? You got the little rose there, which I think is an unnecessary touch, to be real with you. This is kind of cool. The Aegean Origins. I don't know if I said that right. But yeah, we know that there's a spring event coming very, very soon. But again, the fact that this update dropped, it caused a whole bunch of problems. And like, there's a whole bunch of changes that come with it, but it's just nothing that we saw immediately. And it had none of the big features that people were excited for, like the wheel change, the skill lock, all that stuff. It just feels like this update didn't really do anything, right? Like there was a lot of hype, not a lot of hype, but there was hype around the event, right? Especially the Ninja Gaiden thing. Like it just looks cool. The advertising material is cool. And so there's just, you know, that hype around it. And then the update drops and it's like, oh, nothing changed. Oh, it's just a little bit more laggy now. So yeah, that's my two cents on this Ninja Attack event. Obviously, we just have to wait and see, right? Like the update came out, but really the content of the update has yet to come still. And so that's what I'm excited for. I'm excited for what's coming next. I'm excited for the spring event. I'm excited for the Ninja Gaiden crossover. I hope there's a commander. There won't be, but I hope there is if they're good at keeping it a secret. And yeah, I mean, I love this game. I love Rise of Kingdoms. So I was just like, when I woke up and saw that the event didn't or the update didn't change anything, I was like, man, that kind of bummer. Anyway, guys, if you enjoy this video, if you found it useful or entertaining or anything like that, make sure you drop a thumbs up on it. It really does help out the channel a ton. Subscribe to the channel if you're new around here. Click that bell to be notified the next time that I upload a Rise of Kingdoms video. And as always, all my social media links are in the description below. So make sure you follow me over there on Instagram, Twitter, Discord, Facebook. All that good stuff is always down below. And of course, there's also a link there to download Rise of Kingdoms absolutely for free for your PC or your Mac. It's a program called BlueStacks. It's my favorite way to play Rise of Kingdoms. It's free and you can play the game on a big screen. I think that gives you a huge advantage, especially in things like Ark and KVK. So go ahead. What are you waiting for? Click the link, give it a try. And with that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. This has been Omniarch. I will talk to you guys again soon. Peace.